What is the change in specific enthalpy of air as it is heated from 400 Kelvin to 800 Kelvin using all four approaches we covered in the main lecture video? This is the first example for the specific heat's main video. The links to that 12-minute video, the other examples for this topic, and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. From that main video, we learned that the change in enthalpy is equal to the integral from T1 to T2 of Cp dt. The simplest and most accurate way of finding this is to use the tables for air at those specific temperatures. From the ideal properties of air table, we see that the enthalpy at 400 Kelvin is 400.98 kilojoules per kilogram and 821.95 kilojoules per kilogram at 800 Kelvin. Therefore, the change in specific enthalpy is 420.97 kilojoules per kilogram. The second option we have is to find the coefficients of the polynomial fit for Cp bar of air and integrate between 400 and 800 Kelvin to find the change in H bar. This table is usually called ideal gas specific heats of various common gases as a function of temperature, so that you can look it up. With A, B, C, and D, we integrate with respect to T and evaluate at T800 and T400 and subtract to find the value of the defined integral. This is equal to 12,244 kilojoules per kilomole. Since what we want to find is the change in specific enthalpy H, not the change in molar specific enthalpy H bar, we divide this result by the molecular weight of air to obtain 422.66 kilojoules per kilogram. This is very close to our first value, but still an error of 0.4%, which lies on the range of error that even the table acknowledges. The third option is to use the ideal gas specific heat of various common gases at various temperatures table to look up the specific heat Cp at 400 Kelvin and 800 Kelvin, and assuming a linear relationship between those two temperatures, we take the average of these two values for Cp. The change in enthalpy would therefore be this average value for Cp times the change in temperature 800 minus 400 Kelvin. This yields a value of 422.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And finally, the last and least accurate option we have is to assume that Cp is constant and that it is equal to that at 400 Kelvin, what is known as cold properties. Using the value for Cp at 300 Kelvin, we multiply it by the change in temperature and obtain 402 kilojoules per kilogram. So the conclusion to this example is to always use the tables for the exact enthalpy of our substance at that temperature if available. It's the easiest process and the most accurate. If that is not available, then use A, B, C, and D for the polynomial fit and perform the integral version of the expression for enthalpy. If you want to see some other examples in the specific heats and heat capacity topic, make sure to check out the links in the description below. You'll find the other lectures of the thermo course, as well as the other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!